Welcome back to Exotic Astrology, everybody, and today we will continue with the discussion on Bhagavad Gita. We are in the first chapter and we have finished the first three verses. In that, the armies have assembled and Duryodhana has gone to Dronacharya and said, "What a blunder you did by teaching everybody how to fight. Now they are standing against you, and especially Drishtadyumna." Now let us go to the fourth verse. I will recite it three times. Atra sura maheshvasya bhima juna samayudhi yuyudhano viratascha dropadascha maharatha. Atra sura maheshvasa bhima juna samayudhi yuyudhano viratascha Draupadascha Maharatha. Once more. Atra sura maheshvasa bhima juna samayudhi yuyudhano viratascha Draupadascha Maharatha. The meaning is as follows. Here is this army. Here in this army there are many heroic bowmen equal to fighting in Bhima and Arjuna, great fighters like Yuyudhana, Virat and Drupad. He is telling that in our army there are great men who are equal to fighting these people. Who are the people? Bhima, Arjuna, Yuyudhana, Virata and Drupada. Which means he is trying to tell that our army is no less. This is actually an indirect indication of Duryodhana's fear. It is like self-justification. Do you understand? See what he's saying. I will say again. Here in this army, means in our army, there are many heroic bowmen. Not bowmen, many heroic bowmen. Equal in fighting to Bhima and Arjuna. He's specifically mentioning this too, and also other great fighters like Yuyudhana, Virat and Drupad. That means we have people who are equal to these three also. He mentions five people: Bhima, Arjuna, Yuyudhana, Virat and Drupad. The purport is as follows. Even though Drishtadyumna was not a very important obstacle in the face of Dronacharya's very great power in the military act, there were many others who were causes of fear. So basically, it's mentioned that Drishtadyumna was not a very dangerous person. He was dangerous. He was a Maharathi, but he's not that dangerous. These people are the most dangerous. Drupad, Virat, Yudhana, and especially Bhima and Arjuna. They are like the conquistadors of the Spanish army. They are mentioned by Duryodhana as great stumbling blocks on the path of victory, because each and every one of them was as formidable as Bhima and Arjuna. Each one of them means Yuyudhana, Virat and Drupad. Drupad is the father of Draupadi and he is the father-in-law of the Pandavas. And Virat is the father-in-law of Abhimanyu, who is son of Arjuna. Abhimanyu's wife's name is Uttara. They are mentioned by Duryodhana as great stumbling blocks on the path of victory, because each and every one of them was as formidable as Bhima and Arjuna. He knew the strength of Bhima and Arjuna, and thus he compared the others with them, because they were the pinnacle of power. He does not mention Yudhishthir or Nakul or Sahadev, because they were not very prominent in terms of warfare. Although Yudhishthir Maharaj is a Maharathi, but here specifically he compares all these people to Bhima and Arjuna. This reflects the fear of Duryodhana, the horror about Bhima and Arjuna which he had in his heart always, because that shows that the enemy is always comparing. everybody with Bhima and Arjuna. He's not comparing here to anybody with Yudhishthir. That means indirectly how much fearful he is of Bhima and Arjuna. That is being reflected here. So now we will go to the fifth shloka and we will see what is there. Drishtaketuscheta nikam kasi rajascha viryanam purujit kunti bhojascha saibhyascha narapungrava. Drishtaketus cekitana kasi rajascha viryava means purujit kunti bhojascha saibhyascha nara pungava. There are also great heroic powerful fighters like Drishtaketu. Ketu is here. Chekitana, Kashiraj, Purujit, Kunti Bhoj and Saibhya. These are the different warriors who are on the side of the Pandavas, which Duryodhana is mentioning. The sixth shloka goes, Yuddhamanyuscha Vikranta Uttamaujascha Viryavan Saubhadro Draupadeyascha Sarva Eva Maharatha. Is mentioning the sons of the Pandavas. I will repeat. Yuddhamanyuscha Vikranta Uttamaujascha Viryavan Saubhadro Draupadeyascha Sarva Eva Maharatha. There are the mighty Yudhamanyu, the powerful Uttamaja, the son of Subhadra and the sons of Draupadi. All these warriors are great chariot fighters. Maharatha, Sarva Eva Maharatha, very great powerful warriors. Sons of Draupadi, five sons Draupadi had from all the five Pandavas. And he's mentioning about their power, that they may be young, but they are no less. They are extremely powerful. And he's mentioning here, the son of Subhadra. Who is son of Subhadra? He is the most formidable warrior in the battlefield. He is none other than Abhimanyu himself. Then the seventh shloka is, Ashmakam tu Visistvaye tan nibodha dvijottama nayakam mama sainyasa samagrartham tan bravamite. It means, but for your information, O best of the Brahmanas, let me tell you about the captains who are especially qualified to lead my force. So what is happening now? Duryodhana is assessing the armies of the battlefield of Kurukshetra. Duryodhana is assessing the strength of the enemies first, and now from here he is going to assess the strength of his own army. Well, now the question is, Dronacharya already knows who is there on my side, who is there on that side. Dronacharya knows way, way, way beyond than what Duryodhana knows. But why is he coming and speaking all these things? That, okay, in the army of the Pandavas, they are there, he is there, he is there. Dronacharya already knows about it. But he is still coming and speaking it. Because Duryodhana is always cautious and conscious. What if Dronacharya gets fearful and he decides not to fight? So even though he also knows that Dronacharya knows whoever is there on the other side and on our side, let me go and remind him again that you are on our side and the enemy may be powerful, but now from now on he will be speaking from the next verses on who is there on his own army, on the side of Duryodhana. That's what he will be speaking. Till now he spoke about the enemies. So it is like a person, he is taking a scale and he is saying, okay, this side these people are there and now this side we have. This is kind of a self-aggrandizement. This is almost like bragging. okay, they may have this, but we have this. Because if you go ahead and read, Duryodhana will say that our army size is almost double. So this is over exaggeration. When you brag too much, then you tend to over exaggerate things and speak things which are actually not, I would not say lies, but they are not actually true. For example, when you go ahead, Duryodhana will say that our army is almost twice as the Pandavas, but that is not true because you have seven, the Pandavas had seven and they had 11. So 7 into 2 is 14. So 14 and 11 are different, right? But he exaggerates it and he says, oh, our army is almost two times, so nobody can defeat us. So basically what is happening here is in these verses, Duryodhana's inner fear is coming out because he is addressing all the enemies in the battlefield as very powerful. This is a very tactic strategy of politics. He will say, yeah, our enemy is powerful. My enemy, this is there, that is there. But then we have our own strength. Therefore, Duryodhana is perfect to be a politician. There is no doubt. There cannot be any politician like him. So till now, Duryodhana mentioned about the strengths of the enemies. And from here on, he is going to mention about the strength of his own army. Bhavan Bhishmascha Karanascha Kripascha Samatityam Jaya. We will recite it later. If you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up and share it with people. And if you want to donate, then the link to PayPal is there below. Okay, until next time. Bye bye. See you.